In today's video, we will move away from our arowana talk for a while and focus on one of my favorite freshwater fish, the fire eel. Known for its elongated black body with streaks of red, yellow, and orange starting from its head and a very bright red color outer tail rims, this guy will surely add beauty to an aquarium. Now, this fellow right here is actually my fourth fire eel, and it is about 20 to 22 inches in length. I got it from one of the most reputable and trusted fish stores here in the Philippines. So going back to our featured fish, let us talk about some fun facts about the fire eel. It goes by the scientific name Mastacembalus erythrotinia, which I hope I pronounced correctly, and belongs to the classification Mastacembalidae, or better known as the family of spiny eels. Fire eels can be naturally found in the waters of Southeast Asian countries like Cambodia, Thailand, Laos, Vietnam, Indonesia, and Malaysia. In some countries, the fire eel is considered food by people, but because of the beautiful striking color of this fish, it has also become a staple in the aquarium trade. The demand for the fire eel both as food and as an aquarium fish has had an effect on its population, but has not significantly threatened it. Maybe because they repopulate rapidly. Anyway, this species also inhabits lowland waters like floodplains and slow-moving rivers. In its natural environment, the fire eel can grow up to a length of 3 feet, that is 36 inches or around 91 centimeters. However, it is very rare to see one that big in a home aquarium. In fact, the biggest I had was about 30 inches and seemed to stop growing after reaching that size. So, it is more likely safer to say that they grow from 2 to 2.5 feet in a home tank. Also, the fire eel has a life expectancy of 10 years. Now, talking about how to properly care for a fire eel, the first thing that a fish keeper has to keep in mind is that this fish is an escape artist. I mean, it is known to insert itself into almost any hole it can find in the tank. I had one fire eel which was at that time around 12 inches that I thought I lost, but after several minutes of searching in and out of the tank, I found him at the base of my trickle filter. So it managed to go there through the hole of my filter. I also lost one fire eel and found it dry on the floor because it managed to push the cover of my tank. So, as the first requirement in keeping a fire eel is to have a tank that has a tight and heavy enough lid, and the holes in the tank must be smaller than the fire eel's head. Also, remember that I mentioned about its size? This cute eel can grow to a big size, so it means that if you plan to keep one, you'd be needing a big tank. Now, the fire eel is a slow grower based from my observation. I had one that grew from 6 inches to a foot in a little less than a year, but the growth even slowed down after that. And so, when small, which is usually the size of a fire eel we would see at the local fish store, it can of course be reared in a small tank. However, one should consider its size when full grown. So, as a personal recommendation, a 6 feet long by 2 feet wide aquarium would be a minimum. Of course, you can keep a fire eel in a shorter tank since it is able to contort its body, but you would want to enjoy seeing it stretch out and navigate around the tank, right? Another thing to consider when bringing home a fire eel is to provide it with a place of refuge like a driftwood, a cave, or even a PVC pipe. Remember that a fire eel is nocturnal, so this means that they are more active at night or when the surrounding is dark. During the day or when new to the tank, an owner might feel bored because the fire eel might appear inactive or most of the time hides, especially when young. However, it can adjust to its environment in no time and start interacting with the owner and swim around the tank even at daytime or when the tank light is on. Although, this would not mean that it won't need a place to retreat. There might be some instances that it would hide or seek refuge from the driftwood due to chasing of tank mates or simply feels the light is too bright. Plus, I do not know if it is just me, but it is so nice to see your fire eel playing with your driftwood. In addition, a sandy bottom is also preferred by the fire eel since it likes sifting on sand. I also observed that the fire eel likes to bury itself in sand, probably another way of refuge. Now that we have discussed the fire eel's home requirement, let's talk about its diet. A fun fact is that the fire eel can be hand-fed. Once it recognizes its owner, it would trust him that the fire eel would eat from his hand. How does a fire eel bite feel, you might ask? Well, yes, they sometimes bite, mistakenly thinking that your finger is food. But this is nothing to worry about since the fire eel's bite is nothing serious. It only feels something rough like sandpaper sucking your finger. So the fire eel is known to be an omnivorous species, which means it would eat meaty food such as crustaceans, earthworms, or even small feeder fish. It is also said that the fire eel feasts on plant matters, but as for my fire eels, I have never seen them eat plants or veggies. Also, a fire eel can be trained into taking non-live food like shrimps, small fish from the market, or even mussels. Although the fire eel's mouth is relatively small for its size, the rule when it fits the mouth it is food still applies with this fish. Remember also that the fire eel accumulates in size, so the amount of food it consumes increases too. So this means that your bioload would also go up. Regular water change and maintenance are still your best weapon against diseases. Next is the water requirement for the fire eel. This species is known to be hardy and does not require anything special, unlike a discus fish, for example. However, it does well on a tank with a 6.0 to 7.5 pH level and a temperature between 24 and 28 degrees Celsius or 75 to 82 degrees Fahrenheit. Also, a tank with slow-moving water is preferable for the fire eel since naturally it lives in an area where water moves slowly. Now, as for its compatibility and behavior in the tank, the fire eel is a docile fish despite its size, which loves to move around the tank once settled. It can basically be housed with almost any freshwater aquarium fish that would not fit in its mouth. In my case, my current fire eel is housed together with my three Asian arowanas and two albino silver arowanas. He is also joined by two datnoids, an NTT that is around 11 inches, and an Indonesian tiger, which is 6 inches in size. But care must be taken when planning to house more than one fire eel in a tank, since despite its passive behavior with other fish in the tank, it can be quite aggressive with conspecifics. So, if you really got hooked with the beauty of the fire eel and can't resist having more than one in the tank, a good number to lessen fights is to have at least 5 of them. So this pretty much covers our discussion about this exciting to keep creature, the fire eel. But before we go, let us have a short recap of the things we talked about. Remember that in keeping a fire eel, one has to consider having a tight and heavy enough tank cover, tank size, tank decor like driftwood, diet, water parameters, and compatibility and behavior. So again, I hope that you found the video informative and made you think of bringing home a fire eel to add character to your tank. Bye for now.